वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट इन बेसिक केमिस्ट्री कोर्स. इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस सेकेंड यूनिट मेटल करोजन इट्स प्रिवेंशन एंड इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री कंटेनिंग टॉपिक इज द प्राइमरी सेल. सो द प्राइमरी सेल्स इज वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सेल कंटेनिंग डैनियल सेल हैविंग कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्किंग रिएक्शंस एंड एप्लीकेशंस विल बी डिस्कस्ड. सो इन टूडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस another type of electrochemical cell is the secondary cell. So secondary cell will be used for the generation of electricity. So because the electricity cannot be obtained on large scale by the primary cell, the reason is that it needs the replacement of exhausted by new one. Because when one of the time primary cell can be exhausted, they again cannot be reused. Okay, so that's why it require the replacement of exhausted by new one. So that's why the secondary cells will be used, because these secondary cells are the reversible cell in which the chemical energy which becomes converted into the electrical energy, and also in reverse transformation electrical energy which becomes converted into the chemical energy. Okay, so that's why generally we use the secondary cells for generation of electricity. Okay, so the secondary cell means the cell which allows electrical energy to be stored and expended are called as a storage cell or the secondary cell. So that means in these cells the electrical energy can be stored, and again they can be use this stored form of energy. So that's why these cells will be either they called as a storage cell or they will be the secondary cell. So in this secondary cell, the spent electrodes can be regenerated by passing electric current through the cell in the reverse direction. So in that cell, the electric current will be passed in reverse direction, then that times this stored form of energy can be used. Okay. So this process of storing of electrical energy in an accumulator is called charging. So that's why in secondary cells, charging and discharging process can be carried out. Charging and discharging process. We all know the charging batteries will be, these charging batteries having working ways. Firstly, they can store the electrical energy and they will provide the electrical energy. Okay, so charging and discharging process will be carried out in the secondary cell. So in this secondary cell, storage cells are connected in series to make up the storage battery. आपल्या सगळ्यांनाच माहिती आहे की जे घरामध्ये इन्व्हर्टर्स असतात ते इन्व्हर्टर्समध्ये देखील अशाच प्रकारचा सेकंडरी सेल यूज केलेला असतो, किंवा मोठ्या गाड्यांच्या ज्या बॅटरीज असतात ते देखील एक प्रकारे इन्व्हर्टर्स काम करत असतात. त्या ठिकाणी देखील सुरुवातीला एनर्जी जी आहे ही स्टोअर केली जाती आहे, आणि ज्यावेळी गरज पडती त्यावेळी ती एनर्जी आपण ही वापरत असतो. ओके, सो इन सेवरेज त्यामध्ये काय आहे तर जे वेगवेगळे स्टोरेज सेल्स आहेत ते एकमेकांना सेरीजमध्ये कनेक्ट केलेले आहेत, की ज्यामुळे त्यामध्ये एनर्जी जास्त अमाऊंटमध्ये स्टोअर होतीये, आणि जेव्हा गरज पडेल त्यानंतर आपल्याला ती परत पुन्हा डिस्चार्जिंग प्रोसेस करून एनर्जीही मिळवता येते. ओके, सो दिस स्टोरेज सेल विल बी आयदर ॲसिड टाईप ऑर द अल्कलाईन टाईप. So the secondary or rechargeable batteries are generally classified into three categories. They will be classified into three categories. So one of the type of secondary cell is the alkaline storage cell. Alkaline storage cell. Another type is the lead acid storage cell. Lead acid storage cell. Or it will be also called as acid batteries. Another third type of cell is the lithium ion batteries. These are the three different types of secondary cells generally used for generation of electricity. Okay, so one of the main point in the secondary cell is, in this cell firstly they can store the electrical energy, and again after some time this energy can be expended or reused. So these are the secondary cell. So one of the most important application of the secondary cell is these secondary cells can be reused, but in the primary cell once they can exhausted they cannot be used. Okay, so that's why secondary cells will be okay. Next part of this unit and also the last part of this unit is the applications of electrolysis. So in this chapter we also discuss what is the electrolysis and electrolysis process, and last topic we discuss here is the applications of electrolysis. So these applications will be seen in the four types. So first application is the electroplating, second is the electro refining, third one is the electrotyping, and last one is the electrometallurgy. So this discuss one by one. So first form of application is electroplating. So electroplating means in this process which obtaining the metallic coating of a metal, superior metal like silver, gold, nickel, chromium on inferior base metal with the help of electric current is known as electroplating. In this process we use the electric current, so that's why this process is the electrolysis process. Okay, so in this process we coat the base metals. For example, this is the base metal and this base metal will be coated by these superior metals like silver, gold, nickel or the chromium. Okay, by using the electric current this process will be called as the electroplating. So why we use this electroplating will be carried out. So purpose of electroplating will be discussed here. So first purpose of electroplating is the protection of metal from the corrosion. So first why we use the electroplating, because the metal, base metal which get protected from the corrosion, so that's why we carried out the electroplating over it. Okay, so in this protection of metal corrosion we carry out a coating of corrosion resistant metal. So when we protect this iron or the copper metal, so that's why this iron or copper metal will be coated by the corrosion resistant metal, by the corrosion resistant metal. So the corrosion resistant metals are like silver or gold or nickel or the chromium or tin. These corrosion resistant metal will be coated these base metal like the iron or the copper, so in order to protect this metal from the corrosion and the rusting. Okay, so this is the first purpose of electroplating, is the protection of metal from the corrosion. Okay, so second purpose of electroplating is decoration purpose. So for decorating the base metal surface we carry out the electroplating. Okay, so a coating of base metal over the superior metals like silver, gold, nickel, chromium over the base metal is applied in order to increase the beautiful and attractive appearance of the base metal. Increasing the beautiful and attractive appearance of base metal, we carry out the electroplating. It also increases the commercial and decorative value of base metal. Okay, so for example, luxury article making, picture frame making, ornaments coated, these ornaments will be coated with the noble metals like nickel, chromium, silver or the gold with the help of electric current, then that time electroplating will be carried out on the base metal surface and a decoration of this metal will be take place. Okay, so this is the second purpose of electroplating, for increasing the commercial, decorative and attractive appearance of base metal the electroplating will be carried out. Okay, third purpose is the repairing. So for repairing purposes we also carry out the electroplating over the base metal surface. So the broken pieces or worn out machine parts can be repaired by using this electro deposition of metal between the broken parts of the metal. So one of the metal surface will be break by any reason, then that times these broken parts will be rejected for any operation. Okay, so that's why the electro deposition will be carry out on these broken part, then that times these metal again reused for particular purposes. So that's why we carry out the electroplating over these broken parts of the metal. They increase their value. Okay, so this is the third purpose. And last purpose is the achievement of specific properties. So we achieving, or base metal will achieving some specific properties, then so that's why the electroplating will be done over there. So the electroplating of metal is done in order to achieve the specific functional properties. So these specific functional properties like electrical conductivity or wear resistant will be increases. So these specific properties will increases by the metal, so that's why electroplating will be done over there. Okay, so in this electroplating process, so we discuss the electroplating process here. So electroplating process, in this process to deposit one metal over the another smoothly firmly adhering layer, the surface to be covered must be perfectly clean. So when we applying coating over one of the base metal, then that times the surface of this base metal will be very clean. Okay, so surface of this article will be electroplated is clean thoroughly by hot solution of alkali for removing the grease. So when this piece of metal will be electroplated, so that's why this piece will be clean thoroughly by hot solution of alkali. Okay, for removing the grease will be present over there. Then this piece will be treated with dilute HCl. So this process will be called as the pickling process. So that's why the any impurity or any oxide layer will be present over this piece, they can be removed. Then this piece will be washed with water to free from acids and then carefully polished to make it smooth. Okay, so firstly they can washed with alkalis, then they can washed with this dilute acid, and again they can washed with water. Okay, so in three stages this piece can be clean. Okay, and then they can carefully polish to make it smooth. Okay, and then this article will be placed over the rectangular tank. This article will be coated by this. Okay, this article to be coated. Okay, so this article is suspended in the rectangular tank, and this article will be make as a cathode, and the anode is the pure plate of metal whose coating is desired on the article, and also one of the piece of metal will be taken. This metal will be coated over this article. Okay, so this metal piece will be act as a anode. So this anode is a pure plate of metal whose coating is desired on the article, and it is also suspended in this rectangular tank. So both the cathode and anode will be dipped in the solution of electrolyte. So will be dipped in the solution of an electrolyte, and this electrolyte solution, which consists of the salt of the metal which article is to be electroplated. Okay, salt of the metal the will be placed in this electrolyte solution in which the articles is to be electroplated. Okay, so while equivalent amount of anode gets dissolved in the form of metal ions with the liberation of electrons and passes into the electrolyte, then smooth and bright deposits are obtained at low temperature and high current density. The high metal ion concentration of an electrolyte and article is to be coated. So this overall process will be called as the electroplating. So examples of this electroplating is the electroplating of silver on iron spoon, and also the electroplating of copper on iron spoon. Okay, so these examples will be discussed in next video. So today we stop here. Thank you.